So one of the questions that my team and I frequently get, actually always get, is how many treatments do I have before I feel better? Now, if you ask our ECT physician that question, his response will be as many as it takes plus one. The length of time that we perform ECT and the frequency of ECT is determined on a case-by-case basis, and it is very subjective. We go by what the patient and their family report. We are looking for a change in behaviors with the patient. For instance, in a patient who is profoundly depressed, they may not feel like they are better, but their family member may report, "Oh, but my wife is not sleeping 14 hours a day anymore," or "She's up and showering and taking care of the grandchildren," or "She's preparing meals now." The patient may not feel it yet, but traditionally, people who are surrounding the patient see it first. My staff see it first in patients. We can see a change in their gait. We can see a change in the way their faces look. They might start to develop a little bit of a sense of humor that we hadn't seen before. So the physician's response is actually the most appropriate one. As many as it takes to see a response, to have the patient feel that they are better, plus one. We recommend that patients, once they start feeling better, continue with ECT in what we call maintenance. So maintenance for some patients could mean they do it once every 3 weeks. It could mean they do it once every month. It could mean they do it once every 6 weeks. And these patients traditionally stay well if they're seeing their physician, if they're taking their meds as appropriate, and if they see us when they're scheduled to see us. Sometimes when the person has finished maintenance ECT, which is in between the index, and once they finish continuation ECT, and they are feeling 100%, they're keeping their appointments, they're taking their meds, they may opt to discontinue ECT entirely, and that is always the patient's prerogative. And very often, they don't require any more treatments. Sometimes they do have to come back. We call it a tune-up. And if they start to backslide, we encourage them to call us quickly so that we can get them going with ECT again, and they recover more quickly the second time around. The brain remembers.